Hey everyone, this is Anya here at our Gabled home, and on the day that I am publishing this video, it's been exactly 3 years that I've been here on YouTube. So I wanted to say a few things about that. If you're only here to watch this video, how to clean your floors naturally, you can skip forward to this timestamp and then you can get directly to my supernatural cleaning method. However, I thought it would be so fun 3 years later to see what my original how to clean your floors naturally video looked like. It's kind of interesting for me to watch it because I was so stiff and so awkward. And in today's video, I want to show you a really surprisingly simple way how to clean your wooden floors with a damp mop. And to tell you the truth, I still always get a little bit anxious right before I hit record, but I hit record anyways. And I am so grateful for all of you who have been watching my videos, liking my videos, and especially subscribing to my channel. This is 22,000 subscribers later, over 1 million views on my videos, and I just absolutely love engaging with you. I have some what I like to call super fans, and if you are one of them, you know who you are. And I love hearing from you. I love engaging with you. So on that note, I would love to hear 3 years later, as we're going into 2021, what kind of content would you love to see from me most? I'm all about homemaking and homesteading and recipes, a lot of German recipes, because that is my heritage and that is how I love to cook and bake in here at our Gabled home. So if you have ideas, questions, suggestions, any thoughts, just leave me comments below. Also, if you have been commenting on my videos before, I try really hard to respond to every comment I get. I do take the time in my day to go through the comments and respond to them. And I love hearing from you. I love engaging with you. So it's been such a fun journey. I have learned so much from you, but also about how to be better with recording videos and how to make my content as pleasant and watchable as possible. So thank you everybody for being here. Like I said, I am absolutely loving this journey, and I personally have so many more ideas that sometimes I don't think I have the time to make a video about all these ideas that I have. So just stay tuned. And if you are new on my channel, again, my name is Anya here at our Gabled home, where I love sharing our simple heritage homemaking and homesteading journey. I share a lot of recipes and I share a lot of German recipes. If you're enjoying this content, I always, always love it if you give me a like. And if you're new and haven't subscribed, I love it if you hit that subscribe button so you never miss another video. So let's talk about cleaning floors. And there's a lot of methods out there. And if you know anything about me, I love old fashioned, but only if it works. And this method works so well. And what I love about it is that there's no waste. You're not using anything plastic, and it is super sustainable and super effective. So the first thing we need is a wooden broom. And if you're wondering where to find all of these items, you don't need to write anything down. I'll be leaving the links in the box below this video so you can find them. So this is a two-part brush, if you will. This comes apart, and I haven't done this in a while, but oh yeah, here it is. So it unscrews and you can screw it in there. It's actually, and now on camera, I can't get it back in there. That's what I get for showing you how it works. Okay. So this is a scrubber brush. Obviously you can see it's been well loved and well used. So we'll need that. We will need a mop cloth. Sometimes it is called a Cuban mop. This is something that I've grown up with. My grandparents, this is all they did. This is how they cleaned their wooden floors or laminate floors. And essentially it is a very sturdy cloth that you can just toss in the washing machine on a hot cycle. It comes out really easily and it's always clean. If you don't have that, you can always use an old towel. You just want something that has a little bit stiffness and a little bit of body to it, so it makes your job easier. I like to use a pair of gloves. Then we have a pail here, and I always think that it makes my homemaking routine a little easier if I have items that I actually enjoy using. And I love this enamel pail here that I have filled with hot water. I always gotta be careful. So I use the hot water because I think it cleans a little bit better than cold water, but I gotta be careful because we have cats that are super curious and they might actually drink from it just because it's novel and who knows why. So there's a fine line here. If you have animals at home, you wanna be careful to not make it boiling hot, but just warm. And then I love using Celsuds. It's pretty much the only cleaner that I use here at home for my bathrooms, my floors, my dish soap, and it's super versatile. It's biodegradable, it's super natural, it's actually very economical. You only need a little bit. So we will start by putting on the gloves to save the hands. My hands are so hard working, so it's always good to protect them a little bit, even though this is a very mild cleaner and not toxic in any way. But nevertheless, here are my gloves. Then I add a good squirt to my bucket here. I'll take my cloth and dip it in here. You can see I'm already getting a little bit of foam. So now it's dripping wet. And by the way, this Celsuds has a nice pine scent, so that's always really pleasant. So you need to wring it out a little bit, otherwise you're gonna make your floors super soppy wet and it would take a long time for them to dry. And all we do here is put this over the brush, just like so, and then you go ahead and clean. That's really all you do. You can often see what you've been doing by looking at your cloth. My floors, again, are not super dirty, and oftentimes you can just turn it over on the other side and use it on the other side if you've moved on to another spot in your house. And once you have done a good area and you need to do more, you simply dip the cloth back into your water here. And I sometimes find it oddly satisfying to see how brown the water is, because that tells me that it was about high time to clean it. And you wring it out. It's actually very good for your muscles. And then you continue with the cleaning routine. What makes it a lot easier is if you either vacuum your space beforehand or you give it a bit of a sweep, because then you're not pushing dirt around, you're actually just mopping what doesn't come off with vacuum cleaning and sweeping. I hope that you found this enjoyable, and if you're looking for more ideas how to clean your home naturally, I have an entire playlist here. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.
It's very zero waste. It's actually old-fashioned. It's how my grandmother used to clean her floors. And let me show you how that works.